And what could this big announcement that Tony Khan has dreamed of for years, one of the most important announcements ever in AEW, what do you think it is, Mike?
I don't know. What could a guy be dreaming about for years if he loved pro wrestling? Running Madison Square Garden, running the O2 in London, running the Budokan in Japan? I don't know. You know, it doesn't sound like he's going to announce a revelatory talent. Who would be out there that would walk in the door? So I would assume it's something about a card or something about a location or a card in a location all set up. So I think it's probably got something to do with that. But honestly, I really don't know.
See, there are a lot of possibilities here. But to say one of the most important announcements ever in AEW, a huge milestone.
Milestone.
What does that mean? That he cannot wait to talk about. So,
in the world. You mentioned the world.
I mean, to build something. Listen, he's built up a lot of big announcements in the past. Fans have been disappointed by many of them because they then build up things in their heads. But man, this is not building up something in your head when he says it is something he has dreamed of for years. It is a huge milestone, one of the most important announcements ever in AEW. That to me is like, we're announcing our new, we re-signed a new television deal.
Streaming service?
It could be a streaming service, which has been rumored for a long time. Or it could be that Saturday television show in the 6:05 p.m. time slot. Because the key is, you know, there have been rumors about 6:05 and everything. I don't know if it's going to be 6:05 or whatever. We do know almost with certainty that there's going to be a show on Saturday. And, you know, when he first started AEW, it was not supposed to be on Wednesday. It was supposed to be Tuesday. It was supposed to be Tuesday Night Dynamite. That was what the original show was supposed to be. But the station wanted it on Wednesday. And so, you know, when people go, he wanted to go to war with... Actually, he didn't want to go to war with it. He wanted to go on Tuesday, but they wanted it Wednesday. So I don't think that for years he was just randomly dreaming of a Saturday show. Now, as a long-time wrestling fan, perhaps he was dreaming for years to get Saturday 6:05, and now he's getting it. It could be that. But, I mean, I suppose it could be the video game. Could be the video game. Huge milestone, something he's dreamed of for years. One of the most important announcements ever. It could be the video game, because if the video game is a big hit, that's a tremendous, tremendous amount of revenue coming in for AEW. So I guess we'll see tonight.
Mike Sempervivi here with you for the next hour talking professional wrestling, which is something we do every single day here on this program.
What kind of mustache did Vince McMahon have?
Well, goddamn! If you had questions about my mustache, you just had to ask.
My God, Vince, is that you?
Hell yeah, it's me. What are you doing in my chair, kid?
Yeah, listen,
I'm here, everybody, for a moment.
You are.
Because I know the only thing that anybody cares about is this stupid mustache story. I get a text. He's back, LOL. First, I was told he was snuck into the building. I started getting messages. Dude, he's got a mustache. You ever seen Gomez Adams from the Adams Family? That's what his mustache looked like. And he also had jet black hair. I got a sale to facilitate, so I'm out of here.
Shave that thing. My God. Wrestling Observer Live.
I went to Rite Aid.
Oh, no.
And they had, I don't know, I think it was by L'Oreal or something like that.
Just for men.
This is apparently not to be used to color all of your hair black.
Uh-huh.
So I got home, and I just... I start running the water through my hair, and, like, I can't even get my fingers through my hair. I washed my hair like 7-8 times.
Till it fell out?
Finally, I was like, dude, I got to cut my hair off. This stuff is not coming out. I thought I was so clever making fun of him and spoofing his mustache and dyeing my hair black and going in there looking like Vincent Price. And what happens in the end? I end up having to shave my head because of this guy. I think Vince watches this show every week. He goes into the archives. He watches the Retro Raw. He follows along with us.
Okay.
And he was watching this show, and he saw Burt Reynolds. Man, he saw Ron Sheer marking out for this guy, and he was like, that's the secret of mustache.
And he went out and got a blonde with big boobs.
I don't know about that one.
Oh.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.